is time. Confront the remaining pack leaders. Take what is theirs. Embrace the destiny of all Zerg. You must know your enemies. Yedra, a worm whose acid burns like fire. Kraith, immense. Consumed by hatred. Sliven, the Eternal Mother, hollow and destructive. Kill them, and you will command the whole of the Zerg. Each has sent most of its pack against your swarm, leaving themselves vulnerable.
Zagara, defend the Leviathan. I will deal with the pack leaders myself.
It's another peace. One of these one hero missions, not our like an RTS continues. At all. Bullshit stuff, yeah.
My queen, new form, powerful. Can leap through air, strike foes, heavy damage.
We adapt.
I want to mention her animation no looks awful. Like okay, let me just make her patrol. Like, seriously? Anyways, yeah. The quality of Blizzard these days.
New offensive ability, psionic shift. Dash quickly, destroy creatures within path.
So you get a bunch of new abilities. That's why I didn't let us last mission to do anything, so it's just kind of the way it is.
This relic, Zelnaga origin, houses genetic information. Important, must collect.
This world is mine.
Primal roaches, help. They fight Yandra's brood.
You forced my hand.
New form can twist essence, mend wounds, heal nearby Zerg and self.
Boldness.
So you can use the little leap things on whatever enemies you want. Why did that guy deserve to die?
Make your peace.
Are they just like, do they just suffer. Hate those things? Oh, I don't know.
Our conquest continues.
Yeah, they really are.
The swarm conquers all.
They're like, fuck limit. Those things. Oh, I guess it's just what this the feral roaches do. So, unlike most of the other missions, Kerrigan can actually die. So she must survive, so do take that into account. It's really not that hard. Honestly, the little roaches and things that you get don't matter quite too much as you think. Also, take note of the Zelnaga artifacts which are in this area. This is actually kind of a fun one. Kind of go like over here and then... And we're done.
Yes.
Her energy, she only has 100 energy, but it regenerates extremely fast. And this mend ability is actually extremely powerful, especially if you're like in a large group, kind of like this. Well, it's not really a large group, but and what you can do is you can kind of kite them back, and it's really seriously overpowered when you get them in a line like that. It's on the level of ridiculous. You know, it's honestly keeping these guys important alive is not important. You can live without them. And it reinforces you anyways. Like it'll give you more guys, but for these boss fights, it's not important.
Leader of the Broken Pack, no.
Is that fear, Yagdra? You do know you never had a chance, right?
Your change means nothing! I will melt the flesh from your bones!
Okay, every boss fight can be beaten by using just mashing Q.
It's laying eggs. Destroy them!
Like, you just kinda jump up to him and he runs away and he has a bunch of this stuff, you use your ability and then kinda go back. It's really easy to kinda beat this guy. Don't concern yourself with the roaches while being too much.
No time.
Okay, we didn't need that. And there's a bunch of eggs.
I sense your fear.
I mean, if some of them die, then some of them die.
The swarm conquers all.
There we go. You don't want the eggs to hatch because they have like crap in them and it makes it undesirable.
No time like the present.
Her energy just goes back so fast.
Our conquest continues.
This is not like an isolated thing either, because it's kind of it happens all the time.
Yes.
Or like even past this mission.
Stay still.
What a professional. She tells me to stand still. Oh well. And you know what? This is actually StarCraft 2 for you. You know, better boss fights than Diablo 3. Oh, we have to get out of the way. And he's dead. Honestly, the hardest part is keeping all the roaches alive. Like, I lost two during that encounter. And there's nothing up here, so we'll continue on our merry way.
This world is mine. No.
More of my pack. Primal Hydralisks.
Quickly, destroy the eggs before they hatch. Focus on the largest ones first.
So, it's really easy. All you can do is just do this and then use your leap on the last one. So, it's just that little thing like this. The large ones have the Ultralisk things in there. So, you know, just take that into account. You can get a whole bunch of these. These I don't even like to bother with that Ultralisk. So, he comes alive and then you kill him.
Yes.
Honestly, that's probably not a difficult part. Over here, there's a bonus area with four Ultralisk eggs. However, the feral primal, whatever, Zerg are coming at us, so we've got to do this thing. And MLG
no time
it.
Like the present. We adapt.
Unfortunately, these are not cool like my roaches. Like they don't have that slowing down ability. So try and just take out. You can probably get about two eggs. Yeah, I always get about. I've never gotten more than two eggs. That's it. And that thing heals you, so you're okay.
No time like the present.
And you might as well heal because it's free. It's practically free.
We adapt.
All right, let's move back just slightly and get all these guys.
Make your peace.
Unfortunately, the Ultralisk guys spawn.
Our conquest continues.
We kite a little bit.
We are without limits.
Oh, no, no.
No time. Run away.
If a couple of your minions die, it's not a big deal. I could not care less about these guys, because they're really not. Kerrigan can kite everything on her own. To be honest, they're more of a hindrance than a help.
The swarm.
I could probably just leave them behind and do this entire game.
I am the swarm.
There's actually multiple moments where I would honestly say abandon them.
No time like the present.
Alright, here. Oh no, oh, I didn't have enough energy for that. Just get over here. Actually, snap that guy off. And we heal up. Get that guy. And we can just go through these.
Our conquest continues.
And there you go. A little bit of kiting. That's probably the hardest part in this entire mission is that, and it can be easily
like
beaten by both abandoning your minions and kiting with Kerrigan.
Make your peace.
You could probably just burrow actually these guys. No, I don't really know why I didn't like do that. Present. Probably would have been a good idea.
I am the swarm.
Kerrigan moves slightly faster.
Boldly.
So like it replaces them all.
My pack is ready to fight.
World is mine.
I feel your strength. You will be worth killing. Worth the blood.
1,000 cuts.
Shred the flesh.
Yeah, he's that little ability. And all you do is you just move these guys out of the way. And whenever you see these guys coming in, you just do a little W attack. And honestly, once again, I think it's honestly better if your minions just die at some point. Because it's just... they're not going in a straight line for me. So I'm just going to let them do whatever they want. Serve as a distraction. Every time he does that attack, like, more of them come down.
We adapt.
So yeah, I took out most of them, but even then, just like, why? And she can heal herself too. It's like fine. And just attack that guy. By the way, if you get in his path, you don't actually die. I'm kiting now. I guess we'll kill these guys now. Got them all in one hit, see?
Comes for you.
I am the swarm.
And cutting.
We are without limits. No time like the present. Boldly.
He has a lot of trouble hitting us. He's got about like 6,000 HP, but this doesn't mean shit.
Struggle. It only makes you taste.
Hit his own guy.
Make your peace.
1,000 cuts. Shred the flesh.
I love just getting him one hit though. It's kind of fun. But really easy at the same time.
Make your peace.
I think I can get this guy one last hit. Oh no, I can't. Now he's dead.
We are without limit. Make your peace.
Yeah, as you can see, pathetically easy.
Our conquest continues.
My pack arrives. They will break your enemies.
We adapt. The swarm.
So now that we have these feral baneling things, so
these ones explode when they sense you.
Basically, if you kill them, they don't do any explosion damage. However, when they're near you, they go and explode. They don't hurt anyone else though, but they're really easy to take out. You can either take them out by kind of just juking them like that. It's really up to you. How you want to handle them. Kerrigan does it pretty well. And go off to the side over here because there's actually a little reward for us here.
Ravasaur fights with acid. Bring it down quickly.
By the way, the acid does like splash damage or some shit. It's really quite easy to dodge. And they require one leap and one main attack.
Our conquest continues. Make your peace.
Yeah, we're done.
We are without limit. We adapt.
She's the only one who can come up here, by the way. Alright, everyone heal up.
The swarm conquers all. Yes. Retribution
of mine. Just make sure that everyone's
what is it this time?
Having no trouble. There we go. And heal everyone up a little bit.
That
healing
peace.
Ability, way too powerful.
The swarm conquers all. Retribution will be mine. Yes.
All right, let these guys heal up for a second. Okay, so here there's actually we want to split off a little bit because there's these annoying little fuckers here. Let them go blow up. I hate these guys. There we go. There's actually one more jump over here to this guy, and it's really easy. Just go like this. It's right here, and up to this guy. And you got him. Nothing else over here, as far as I can see. So whatever. And now go have a good time with Banelings. By the way, they do hurt this guy right here, so just go right around them. Have fun with it. Bring around the Rosie.
Our conquest continues.
Alright, we're done. See what I mean? She can just solo everything, so it's like, why am I doing a brutal tutorial?
If you
actually look this video up, you should be ashamed. Nah, I'm just kidding. I love you anyways. Oh look, some of them respawned. Or something. Yeah, I just had killed these guys, so I don't really know why they're back, but we'll just run past them. It's okay, guys. Okay, let's heal up. And do this.
Our conquest continues. Make your peace. No time
present. Alright, heal up a little bit more. Kill this guy. And leap again. And heal up. It's like the people who tested the brutal campaign had no idea what kiting was. And let's kill this guy. Alright. Well, I think we're almost at the next boss area. This is like just a boss run constantly.
More of my pack joins you.
We adapt.
Excellent.
We are without limit.
And now we have a full force. Kill that thing. Can we get a nice checkpoint here in case you didn't make one?
I am the swarm.
Oh my god. Okay, just abandon your guys there. Let them die. This is Kerrigan's fight. By the way, this person is voiced by an actual Blizzard Activision shareholder. More, there must be more. Like, this is, you know, I don't know if you could tell this, but this is the most, like, I hate this mission. It's disappointing in so many ways. And since when do boss fights belong in a StarCraft game? Alright, you guys want a little pro tip? Okay, wait until your energy's 100, use this, and then go away, and use this slide thing to go away. And then you just simply kite on the edges. Go again. By the way, the little pools of poo gas, they do slow you down and cause damage, but, you know, it's not really a problem. And so there I just use like two leaps. And the leap is like, it's 150 damage, which is more than what those minions you had would ever do. So you can just, continuously move around, you can just dodge everything here. It's just, it's really sad. It really is. They thought this was brutal. I'm not even good at micro. But this is making me feel like I'm amazing at it. You know? Oh, I must be great. I'm dodging Banelings out the wazoo. But no. And those little guys come out. There you go. Two little attacks. I don't think that actually hurts, the Baneling attack, hurts the boss here. I would assume that they're immune to it, but whatever. We're almost done here. Now we're done.
With power, I
I wondered when you would make your move.
No allegiance but to self. Kill or be killed. You know this.
Of course.
One will be consumed and become something greater than either. This is the heritage of the Zerg.
Hey, look, it's Diablo 3 Act Boss. Okay, move these guys to all the way up here. And this is the kind of retarded part is you'll sometimes just lose guys for no good reason. And it's better to kind of let his attacks kind of deal with some of the damage.
This is the only way. This is the destiny of all primal Zerg.
Fortunately, I lost some more guys here. I honestly really hate boss fights, and I should really have no business hating them in a game like StarCraft. So I'm kind of shifting around. I'm trying not to go where they spawn because that's just asking for it. So literally we're just like shuffling around. And hopefully you just hope that he does damage to his own guys. And it literally tells you where he's gonna attack, but it's like, it's just so dumb. And if you lose too many guys, it's just gonna get to a point where you can't win. At this point, he will not be spawning any more guys, so you actually don't have to worry anymore. But there's those little poo gas things in the middle there. Whatever the hell these are, you guys just avoid those. It's honestly, like, really not that hard at this point. It's, you just want to get into this stage. Then you just pretty much win. If you possess half a brain cell, you can even use a leaf to get out of the way of this little attack if you really want to. That's the most boring thing. I'm not playing an RTS right now. I'm playing some kind of stupid-ass Diablo game. Apparently they didn't fuck that up enough. Well, we're done. I'm sorry, boss fights don't belong in a game like this, so I'm going to be pissed off about it.
Zerus is mine. Isha, prepare the Leviathan. It's time the Swarm returned to the Kaprulu sector.
Yay, so what do you got? So you complete it, you kill 500 units with Kerrigan, you kill like 600. There's also, don't let Kerrigan drop below, I got her to 6 life apparently at one point, I don't know when that happened, but whatever.
My queen, I have been contacted by Kalisa, a broodmother. She has heard of your accomplishments, and wishes to return her brood to the Swarm. Her brood is small in number, but it has strong leviathans.
Kalisa, hear me. The planet Mistef 4 is a hub of Dominion military production. Take your brood there, and destroy it. Do that, and you will earn your place within the Swarm.
It shall be as you say, my queen.
My queen, your transformation has altered your abilities. If you wish, you can review the changes within your chamber. It is a good sign that some of your brood mothers are returning to the fold.
I wonder why they are willing to give up their independence.
Perhaps not all of them wish to rule the Swarm.
And perhaps they know there is safety in numbers. Did you know the Ancient One would turn on me?
Your essence, it called him.
And you didn't try to warn me?
He was Zerg. You are Zerg. One dies, and one grows strong. You know.
I think I'm starting to understand you, Dahaga.
By the way, every time you talk with this guy, he talks about fucking essence. You know what? Let's start a drinking game. Every time I talk about biomass or essence, take a shot. I guarantee you will not survive through this campaign.
There is no other creature like you in the swarm. Where did your essence come from?
Take a shot.
The Overmind spun me from many species, a brood of one.
What did you do after the Overmind died?
Wandered the tunnels of Char, without purpose. Pharaoh, Queen of Blades, found me, made me Zerg again.
You aren't Zerg, unless you're under someone's control.
Without overriding will, am beast-less.
Alright, well, we have evolution mission.
Hydralisk strain, ready for augmentation. Expeditionary brood discovered ancient Zerg essence in Dominion space. Brood under attack. Limited time. Planet Merrick 5. Swarm Hive Cluster under assault.
Prometheus, the Dominion's infestation specialist. We need to move fast.
Essence nearby. Overmind creation. Impaler colony. Slow attack. Incredible damage. Collect essence. Adapt Hydralisks. Defeat Dominion.
Yeah, Impalers. Well, you can pretty much see they're a little slow attack. It's like another boss battle. You're playing the Hydralisk shuffle. That's what you're doing. You know, even when I'm up close, it takes the same amount of time, so it doesn't even matter.
Examining. Sequence incomplete. Must kill remaining Impaler colonies.
Are you a bad enough dude to do simple micro? There we go. Just move all the time. This is probably a lot easier. I'm really lazy, I'll be honest. Oh, look, that one collected automatically. Do I have that upgrade? No, these are normal Hydras. How much damage do these guys do? 45. These guys have 60 health. They could take two hits to begin with.
Sequence acquired. Spinning Impaler essence into Hydralisk morph.
Yeah.
Hydralisks now able to morph into Impalers.
This cocoon contains a Hydralisk morphing into an Impaler. Why, thank you.
Impaler attacks while burrowed. Damages single target. Tears through armor.
Move to the high ground and assault their barricade.
Something just busted out of the ground!
I like these guys. They're like snipers.
Destroyed.
That missile turret can detect our impalers while burrowed. Take it out first.
Keep it together.
I just get focus fire down. Alright, sniper fucking lurkers. I love these guys. I should use them more. I didn't really use them in my own run. They have a lot of health too and shit. Oh, by the way, it should be over.
Barricades destroyed. Only Prometheus Company base remains.
Should be fairly obvious what I'm planning on going for. Oh no, I lost a single lurker. Oh, the poor Thor is depressed about life. That'll be enough. The poor Thors. I like Thors. See, this guy's like a range of 6, mine 11. Which is convenient. This is, I think, useful for the campaign.
Terran forces eliminated. Alternative Hydralisk morph possible. Surviving lurker dens discovered. Planet Caver, once birthing colony for Dagoth's brood, now feral. Feral lurkers, survivors of interswarm conflict.
I can control them, but I can't morph more.
Key transformation sequence missing. Requires lurker den. Secure nearby den. Return essence to swarm control.
Take another shot. They said essence. What does it even mean? Like, it's we need to make a word for this, but we can't figure one out.
The feral Zerg have sensed us. Burrow quickly.
It literally tells you where to burrow.
Lurker attacks many foes while burrowed. Effective against light enemies.
Yeah, they can one hit.
More feral Zerg. Burrow quickly and attack.
And the AI is set to dumbly move over my guys. Alright. Oh no, secure this.
Destination reached. Broodmother Kilisa inbound to extract essence. Overlords en route.
I sense the feral Zerg moving. They're attacking from the south. Defend the lurker den.
Can you tell I'm bored?
Another wave incoming. Keep them off the lurker den.
How convenient then. They just kind of wait here for me.
Feral Zerg defeated. Broodmother ready to extract essence.
Take another shot.
Must prepare sequences for Hydralisk morph. Returning to evolution pit.
Shit, we could just do a drinking game whenever they say essence.
Hydralisk morph ready for integration. Await decision.
Obviously, I would pick the railgun strain.
Evolution complete.
Eh. Oh, I'm gonna scratch his nose with my mouse. Well, we're done here. We also have some Kerrigan upgrades.
The powerful essence of the Primal Pack Leaders has awakened a new column and many abilities. As new tiers of abilities continue to awaken, you will gain abilities in this third column as well.
So, we have a lot of changes here. So, basically for the first row, it's Kinetic Blast again. And we also get this new Leaping Strike, which we used during the other mission. Remember, Kinetic Blast, best thing. We also have that Crushing Grip, Chain Reaction, and also now the Psionic Shift. I still am a big fan of Chain Reaction because it's passive. We also now get Zergling Reconstitution, Improved Overlords, and Automated Extractors. This is actually a real tough one, but I actually choose Automated Extractors, believe it or not, because I don't use Zerglings too much later on. I know it's free Zerglings, but still, I don't use them as much as you think. I can still get a lot of Overlords pretty easily, so that's not really a problem, so I might as well go for this one. There's Wild Mutation, which is what I was using before to basically create tanking units, spawn Banelings, and Mend, which basically heals everything around you. You will hover in the center of your Roach Hydra groups, and this will heal them, a lot, you know? So, keep this on. This is actually fantastic. Very, very OP, actually. Last one is, you can get two drones. For at no additional basically they take up 0.5 drones each, supply each. Your units gain increased life regeneration and 30% increased attack speed on the creep, which is quite nice. But the creep tumors attack faster. And there's also Vespian harvesting efficiencies increased by 25%. So, here's my justification for all this. This is nice for early mining, okay? And it could replace automated extractors potentially, and this is a solid choice. You can get a lot of resources early on. I don't go for it though. And I'll give you my justification in a little bit. There's also this one, and I think this is actually the good one, because 30% attack speed and more increased life regeneration means your forces will stay alive for longer if you do creep spread and you do a lot of attack damage. But this won't really help when you're actually moving forward and attacking, so it's up for debate. I really am torn between these two. And Vespian gas efficiency, I actually wouldn't take that, because automatic extractors, you can, if you don't need minerals, you can just place the geysers like across the map without a hatchery being there. And it's really, you know, you just get your gas anyways. Costs you nothing, basically. I'm actually going to take twin drones to get an early economy going, because it's much nicer than you actually think. More than this, because you can just replace the units you lose and shit like that. And I honestly, I don't like concentrating that much on creep spread. Which means, like, why would I have automatic extractors? I don't actually know why. I'm actually torn between this, because I've only done a little bit with this, and, you know, this passive overlord ability means you have to construct less of them, and they come in instantly, but it's just a poor passive. I honestly, maybe I'll keep it on the Zergling reconstitution, because it just doesn't seem necessary to have that on. And the last ones is you can have Kerrigan's cooldown and energy cost reduced by 20%. She has the Fury thing just like before, and the Infest Broodlings. And the new thing she also has is drop pods, and with the Leviathan and the Apocalypse. So that's basically it with that. It's a hard choice with some of these, because some of these are really good. I do like some of these. So it's ultimately up to you what to pick in the end. But that's what I do now. And so let's travel to another planet.
The Terrans launched thousands of these devices at our broods on Char. Broodmother Kalisa relayed this to us. It is not a weapon.
It's a two-way communicator.
The Queen of Blades. I knew you'd return to your true form. A monster. Now, you'll do exactly as I tell you if you care at all about Jim Raynor. Yes, he's alive. So you'll keep your swarm away from Korhal and away from me, or he dies. That man sacrificed everything to give you back your humanity. And you threw it away. Oh, he must be disgusted by you. Why, he'd be first in line to kill you.
I can't sense Jim out there. If he is alive, nothing in this universe will stop me from finding him.
Yeah, don't tell me you didn't see that plot twist coming. It wasn't even a real plot twist. It's a shitty plot.
One of our broodmothers in the Kaprulu sector is picking up a strange psionic signal. It is Zerg, but not part of the swarm.
I know you seek to topple Mengsk. His alien soldiers, the hybrid, are your greatest threat. If you wish to stop them, meet me at these coordinates.
If the Dominion is controlling Hybrid, our invasion of Korhal will fail. This lab must be destroyed. My queen, the infested Terran who contacted you waits over there. He claims to know you.
Who are you?
You do not recognize me? I am Alexis Tokov,
We were enemies once.
Well, we both seem to be Zerg now.
Indeed, and we share a common goal, the destruction of this facility. It is here that Manxk breeds the hybrid, combining Protoss and Zerg DNA to create monstrous creatures of immense power.
Then we'll destroy this facility together.
Now, I know what you're thinking, and you're thinking, what the fuck? Why is this guy alive? We pretty much saw him die in Brood War. He's as dead as he possibly could be. Is Blizzard bored and they just couldn't think of any more main characters? They've been killing off all their main characters, so they had to bring some back, or some stupid shit. Let me explain to you why. Joe Schmo, one of my good friends, told me about this, and apparently in StarCraft 64, I kid you not, the Nintendo 64 version, there's actually a hidden mission where you bring Strukov's body somewhere in the Zerg campaign or something, where, and you bring him, basically, you infest him and bring him back to life, okay? Who the fuck played StarCraft 64, and why is that considered canon? That was considered to be a piece of shit game, and they consider that canon. Okay. I'm speechless.
This isn't just about getting rid of the hybrid threat, is it? Why are you helping me?
They held me here for many years. I survived experiments, torture, and worse. Now I will see it burn. You were the only one I could think of with the power and will to aid me.
Infested. Held captive. Experimented on and hunted. We have some things in common.
Who fucking designed this guy? It's like, oh, his cheek is on fire and his eyes are on fire. Yeah, that looks infested.
Contact the brood mothers. Tell them to bring their leviathans to this system.
Should they unleash their broods upon the station?
No. Zagara and I will lead our broods in the assault.
So the other broods will simply hold in orbit?
I want them nearby. After we destroy this station, we're going after Jim. This is the source of Minsk's hybrid? Just getting inside is going to be an achievement.
The infested Terran. I have never seen his like. He is powerful, but closed off. Where is he from?
Stukov is from Earth. A few years ago, they sent an invading force here. I remember it. I destroyed them.
As it should be.
I thought Stukov was killed. I heard reports that he'd been resurrected, that he'd been infested, then cured. If he's been a prisoner here all these years, anything is possible.
Organism Stukov, fascinating. Implications disturbing.
How so?
Modifications of Stukov, second only to modifications of Primal Queen of Blades. However, Stukov, product of specific design. Interweaving of Terran and Zerg matter, subtle. Spun on micro scale, not possible for Swarm.
Something out there is better at this than you, and you don't like it.
Entity responsible for Stukov exceeds Organism Abathur, untenable to oppose. Recommend immediate indoctrination into foreign entities, Swarm.
Never.
Well, that's all the shit we have here to do, so we'll do whatever the hell this station is next time. Bye.